Hawe jade wakanda etawe. Hawe jade wakanda etawe. Hawe jade wakanda etawe. Hawe jade wakanda etawe. Hawe jade wakanda etawe rohe. What that means is this is God's day, is what that song. That's one of our more simple and first learned prayer songs. Holism is about everything being parts of the whole. And you cannot have health without the land. You cannot have good food without the land. Our Iowa word for, we don't have a word for wilderness, because to us, it wasn't wild, it was our home. We have a word, moetanani, which means a place of the wild food. And so that's what the land was. You depended on it for your food, for your existence. It was your mother, your hina. It wasn't a it and us, it was an us.
We're sitting at the edge of the Iowa Tribal National Park here on the Iowa Reservation, and it's a lot of what the original landscape might have looked like here prior to colonization. And so we have this opportunity to not only reestablish connection with lands that are now our reservation, but do that in a way where we're also putting our land stewardship practices back in place that were intentionally taken away from us through assimilation practices, whether that was through the mission or otherwise being acculturated into the dominant society. Food comes from more than just what we recognize as farms. So historically, and still in many ways, you know, our people and other indigenous peoples have procured our food from a lot of different areas. Yes, we've always been farmers as Iowa people, maintained our berry patches and our pawpaw thickets. And we've also followed the buffalo always and made sure that the health of the entire landscape is such that it can actually provide those foods also. And actually not just for our benefit as humans, but also making sure that all the other animals and the soil also can remain to be nourished. Like anywhere, you know, in Kansas, water flows usually downstream. And so the impacts of what we do here, we know are gonna affect our neighbors downstream. And so how can we make sure that we're, you know, not poisoning the lands, that we're not otherwise adversely affecting the people that come after us, both literally after us downstream, but also the generations that come after us?
The Iowa tribe doesn't do anything small. They're putting regenerative ag practices in on almost everything they do. So we're focusing really heavily on the row crop ground right now, as we're building infrastructure at different parts of water and fences on the farm for adaptive grazing. They've got honeybees. You know, there's a lot of different definitions of regenerative, and from my perspective, it's leaving things better than what they started out to try to actually improve the soil for future generations. The conventional model is really hard to overcome. Fertilizer is always part of it, herbicides are always part of it, and we still use some of those tools. We're trying to take something from a chemical system to a biological system. Everything in the conventional world is chemically driven.
Education is going to be a big thing, you know, especially if we have, we've got a USDA grant application in. It's the Climate Commodity Smart Grant. Producers and consumers can come in here. They can get classroom work, and then also we'll do some field trials and demonstrations out in the field to show kind of what led us to this, and they can look at our results and see where we're at and where we're heading, and we can provide hope for other producers and consumers across the whole world.
You gotta figure that the USDA says some of these herbicides and fungicides, and even some pesticides, do not kill bees. Well, the bees collect it, still collect the nectar from the flowers that have been sprayed, or the pollen that's been sprayed, bring it back to the hive. They feed their developing larvae, which is where the problem comes. It's a developing life form. You cannot feed it poisons whatsoever.
Wow, nice brood in there. Nice looking bees.
So yeah, I think that plays a big role in the bees' health, for sure. GMO crops too as well. It seems like they don't do well around them. You know, it's not healthy for the bees, because the bees will collect pollen off anything that's close and handy, including corn.
It is a village site and mound site, burial mound site, dating from about 1200 to 1400 AD. What I am is a THPO, a Tribal Historic Preservation Officer, and it's a program through the Park Service to allow tribes to have sovereignty over projects on their own land. A lot of people don't know the history here. Part of our goal is to help tell that history so they understand our ancestors in a better way, a more full way, and how they were connected to land. Yeah, oh, and by the way, it was first seen when Lewis and Clark came up the river in 1804 in July. They stopped at the mouth of the Nemaha and went up to the top of this bluff here and said that this country showed signs of being once thickly inhabited. There were so many burial mounds and signs of human remains and things like that around here.
I am an Iowa tribal member. Sitting behind me here is a stone from Louisa Brin.
She was my third great-grandmother.
And she is the line where I get my indigenous heritage from. When I come up to this hill, I sit here and I think of all of the people that have come before me. I don't know their names, I don't know who they were, but I can feel them here. I like to look out and just imagine if they were seeing the same things I am. I'm tearing up. But I think more than anything, this is my home. And it's really exciting that everyone has welcomed me with such open arms and continues to be willing to teach me and educate me on things I'm unaware of or unknowing of. I grew up not really knowing much about my native heritage. But when I was in elementary school, we'd go to powwows, and I didn't really understand why, but eventually when I went into high school, I started to understand what was going on. More than anything, what I'm learning is that we are as connected to one another and as connected to our lands as could be. We are made from the same stuff. We are all one, and we need to respect that and lean into that and figure out what that means for all of us. Our Mother Earth will feed us, she will give us everything we need if we treat her correctly. And I think that we have kind of lost that in our country.
And so we hope that as Native people, we can model a way of doing that, where we're thinking about everyone and everything, knowing that we can't be healthy if our neighbor upstream isn't healthy, and you know, vice versa, right? And so there has to be an understanding of that interrelationship that we have as human communities, and how that is also directly tied to the health of our non-human community.
There is never one plant growing in nature. You know, the prairies had hundreds of species. You know, one on one doesn't make two in nature, one on one makes 10. So the more of you get, the more diversity, the more soil life you get, the more above ground life you get, the more wildlife you get. Nature loves diversity. What we're seeing is what's happening in the soil: healthy soil, healthy plants, healthy animals, healthy food.
This reconnection to the land that we are all experiencing here on the reservation through our regenerative agriculture is really a way to get back to the way things were. It's a way to move us forward, but still remembering and using the tools that our ancestors were using. There are many people that don't understand what the tribe is trying to do. So we need to make sure that what we are doing is thoughtful. We need to make sure that those seven generations in the future have a place to live that is vibrant and full of life and a way for them to live. If we don't make a change, we won't have that option. All of us are indigenous to somewhere, and all of our ancestors knew what I'm talking about. All of our ancestors understood that we have to live in balance, and we aren't currently living in balance. That change is going to be difficult, but it's for the best. It's wonderful. It's a beautiful thing. It's a beautiful change. It's somewhere we need to be headed towards.